This 1-ton R410A refrigerant mini split outdoor air conditioning unit has ice on its suction pipe. So today, in this video, I will tell you the main reason for ice forming on the suction line of the air conditioner. The owner of this air conditioner called another technician to check this problem, and the other tech told the owner that the refrigerant had leaked out of this unit, so the ice was forming on the suction line. The owner refused to charge refrigerant in the AC unit. The owner called us to check what the problem is. When we arrived at the site, the conditions were different here. The suction pressure of this unit is 90 psi. That's the reason the technician said that the refrigerant had leaked out. But the actual problem is something else. The electricity consumption of the air conditioner is 2.2 amperes, and it is consuming a maximum of 3 amperes. Always remember that whenever ice starts forming on the air conditioner's suction pipe, it means that the refrigerant has overcharged, whether an inverter or a non-inverter air conditioner. The ice formation is adjusted in the inverter air conditioner, as the inverter AC compressor works at a variable speed. But in the non-inverter AC, if the refrigerant overcharges, the ice on the suction pipe will be shown immediately. The refrigerant in this air conditioner is not too high nor too low. I am opening the screws of the outdoor for servicing and cleaning it. Let me confirm you that the fault in this air conditioning unit is in the indoor unit. This is the indoor unit mounted on the wall. Now I have removed the air conditioner from the wall. And I will clean this indoor unit, but before doing it, let me explain why ice is forming on the suction pipe. As you are seeing, the blower of this indoor unit is very dirty and full of dust. The evaporator is also very dirty, and the evaporator coil's fins are completely blocked. When the evaporator coil is blocked and completely choked, the cooler gas will flow toward the suction pipe. And as when the gas cools, the molecules of the cooled gas get shrunk. This is why we see ice, as well as the pressure on the suction line, decrease. After cleaning the evaporator coil, the air circulation inside the evaporator coil will increase. And thus, the cooled refrigerant, which is in the form of liquid inside the evaporator, will be blown out as cool air with the help of a fan motor blower. Then this way, the refrigerant, which will flow towards the suction pipe of the outdoor unit, will be warmer, and thus the molecules of the warmer refrigerant will increase, making the ice stop forming on the suction pipe. The pressure on the suction pipe will also increase. This is what the theory says. Let's perform it practically and check whether the issue resolves or not. Now I am cleaning the evaporator with a brush to make all that dirt out of the fins. I have also cleaned the outdoor unit as well. Now I have mounted the indoor unit back on the wall. The airflow of the air conditioner is now better than before. Let's go and check the outdoor condition. The outdoor unit is now consuming 2.7 amperes after starting the compressor. And you can see no ice forming on the suction line pipe. Now let's check its running pressure. As the other tech said, the refrigerant is low. I didn't charge refrigerant in it, and the pressure is now 140 pounds per square inch. The pressure will stand at 125 to 135 pounds per square inch as the compressor speed increases. And this is how you can fix the suction ice problem in an air conditioner. Click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch our next videos. And subscribe. It's free. Thank you.